Hi and welcome back to another quick tip tutorial. My name is Alex and in this tutorial I'm going to try to explain to you how you can unwrap this kind of already sculpted subtools in ZBrush using 3DsMax. So first of all you have to select the subtool and go to the lowest subdivision level under geometry or press shift and D until you get to the lowest subdivision level, and then you just have to export it as OBJ, let's name it brick, and import it into 3DsMax. Import and select brick and make sure you have preset set to ZBrush. This is very important or you're going to have problems afterwards. So import, it's going to import as editable mesh, add an unwrap UV modifier to it and open a new the UV editor, turn off this and select polygons, control A, select all polygons, mapping, flatten and select use the default values, click OK, then go to edge selection and just select them holding Alt to deselect the ones that you don't want and then just click here on stitch to stitch them together again. And last part, then I normally select everything and straighten selection and maybe relax custom couple of times, move it into the canvas, R to resize it, W to reposition it, close this down and just export it. Export selected, let's call this brick max, also OBJ. Click on save, make sure you have for the preset ZBrush again selected and click on export. Make sure you don't have any warnings and click on done. Go back to ZBrush, make sure you have the subtool that you just unwrapped in the 3DsMax here in ZBrush selected and on the lower subdivision level, then just go to import and import the OBJ that you just exported from Max. Now it looks like nothing happened, but make sure you have to go to the highest subdivision level by pressing D on the keyboard or just sliding the slider on, and then just go back down to lowest subdivision level, and now you can under normal map click create normal map and it will create normal map with the UVs and that you applied in 3DsMax shown, and also displacement map, and it created a perfect displacement map. Then just clone it and normal map, also clone it, and under alpha flip vertically and under texture flip vertically, and then just export it as textures, save it, name it, and that's it for this tutorial. Check out the rest of my videos on my YouTube channel, especially these three ones that are going to come in handy for this tutorial that you just saw. Here is a tileable brick floor that is all created in ZBrush, and here these two are created with masks that we created in Photoshop and then applied to the models in ZBrush. So subscribe to my channel if you're not subscribed already. Comment this video, like it, share it, and till next time. Bye.